Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to the Abundance Tree Podcast. I'm the host, Janice Luke, and I'm here with my co-host,
April Cooper.
Love April.
What's up, Janice? How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you doing today?
I'm hot. I ain't ready for this
Yes,
heat. It's hot. It's
it's starting to
hot.
get warmer, isn't it? Spring is here, and we're moving swiftly into summer, aren't we? Or trying to.
Yeah, heavy on the swiftly. Yeah, it's hot outside.
Right. Well, you look nice though. Oh, I'm digging the blue look and like the jean jacket and everything. So in the
Thank
hoods.
you.
Yeah, look nice as always.
Yeah. Thank you as well. I'm loving the army green. Is it we're looking it's not even an army, it's like a light springy green. I'm just yeah, I'm transitioning from the fall to the spring to the well, really we ain't got no spring. It's like fall to winter to summer, I mean.
Right. And winter was very mild this year too, so
It was.
but all good. So we have a bomb guest tonight. I'm really excited.
We really do. He is a pioneer in the Never Work the 40 movement, which is dedicated to helping entrepreneurs achieve six-figure success with part-time commitment. After experiencing a corporate layoff shortly after his wedding, he took control of his financial destiny and became a successful business owner. With a proven launch system, he empowers others to leverage their strengths, delegate tasks, and achieve $20,000 days. 20K days. I need one of those through what's called plat. I'm sorry. That's not platform. Phantom launching. Okay. 20K days through phantom launching. So we're gonna watch a video and I'll let the video speak for itself for him.
About to do a presentation. This is all still very new to me, but this is just going to be the one of the first of many, and I'm just excited to bring value to everywhere I go and just help people like majorly grow their businesses.
I could not like live without her. So like I can't do anything. I am not a normal functioning human being. So with that being said, she has not proofread anything on the sheets or in this presentation.
Oh, no.
So there is a probably a 100% chance there are spelling errors.
And I can feel it coming. It's been so many nights, it's been so hard, so many nights where I just want to cry, where I just want to give up, where I feel like I was wasting my time. People tell me I'm wasting my time. I know my breakthrough's right around the corner. And one day I'm gonna look back and like, man, I don't even know why you're worried in those moments. Everything came together.
Went up on stage, he did the Clark Kent. Everybody went from Clark Kent to Superman. It was that energy.
Jeremy, he is an inspirational, motivational, get off your butt type of speaker.
I got one question for you. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Are you ready? Let's bring them all out. I'm excited.
Me too. We have Jeremy Funderburk joining us.
Ooh,
Jeremy, show yourself. There he is. Jeremy, how's it going?
Awesome.
Queens, what is going on? How are y'all?
Oh,
doing good.
King. Thank you. You have an awesome intro video.
Thanks. Sure do. We ready after that. We are ready.
Okay, we are ready. Turn up.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Always high energy. Always high energy.
Awesome. Thank you so much for coming on with us tonight.
Oh, yeah. My pleasure. I just want to start off by saying thank y'all for one, just having me, for sharing me with your audience, and just accepting me into your energy and your culture and your environment And I just love what you guys are doing. I love how you guys are just bringing so much value to the community and to the world. So flowers to y'all. And I just appreciate you for just bringing me on the journey.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And thank you for coming on and sharing your journey, which is so valuable, and your expertise with entrepreneurs and people. I was reading about these 20K days through Phantom Launching. Is that what it's called?
Yep, that's right. 100%.
Oh, that's awesome. So I can't wait to get into that. But we want to know about you first. Tell us about yourself and your journey.
Yeah, I like to tell people I'm just a guy. I'm just a basic, regular guy. You know, nothing special about me, right? I'm basically high school educated, two-time college dropout. You combine both the times I went to college, it still don't equal a freshman year. So, like, I'm not some genius. I'm just a guy who just, I was committed. I worked through corporate America, wanted to provide, you know, for a family, right? As I was getting married, taking corporate sales job, became a multi-million dollar producer and hit my annual goal in 3 months. And my reward was getting laid off 3 weeks after getting married.
You hit your annual goal in 3 months and they laid you off?
Yep. I came in and they basically said, dude, you rocked it. Thanks for everything you've done for us. We don't need you anymore.
Wow. That is so grimy.
Yeah.
That seems to be like the norm. Like, you know, work for the corporate or work for the business and you build them up. And then once you've done the work and built them up and got them to where they needed to be, you're no longer valuable. That's just ridiculous. But
unfortunately,
it's small-minded. Yeah. It hurt them more than it hurt me looking back, because now I'm doing great. And they just want me to do $1 million in sales for them throughout the course of the year. I did that in 3 months. But when they laid me off, they didn't realize I was negotiating a $1.8 million a month contract for them.
Wow. They're lost totally. And I got to disagree with you. You are extremely special. I don't think that you finishing school and stuff. I'm a high school dropout too. I don't think that, you know, that takes away from you being special or you being important or you being valuable. So you are special.
If
nobody told you today, the abundance. we telling you you're special, huh?
Right. This is all about building success in non-traditional ways. And so you certainly have done that and you're well on your way. That's awesome.
Exactly. I appreciate y'all.
Yeah, absolutely. So what happens after they laid you off? I mean, did it like bring you down? Like, how did you?
Yeah, right after your wedding.
That's crazy. I know. I'm like, what?
Nah. The non-PC version is, I thought I was about to catch a case. They laid me out. I was ready to meet them outside the next morning. And my wife's like, nah, you just need to calm down. Right. So, because at the end of the day, I married my wife because I want to be with my wife, not spend the next 25, 30 years in prison.
So, right? No, yes.
No, she's a good way to start out.
Yeah, and I'm blessed. I got the most supportive wife on the planet. So a lot of events followed after that, but it really just came down to me saying, I'm just not comfortable putting our financial future in the hands of somebody else. And I'm like, if I can do $1 million in sales cold calling for this other company, I can make at least six figures working for myself. Because at the end of the day, I know lead generation, I know marketing, I know sales. So I was like, I'm mad at them for laying me off, but they paid for all the leads while I worked there. I got paid to practice and learn sales on their leads. So this was paid training for my own business.
I know that's right. Turn that tragedy into triumph.
There you go. Right. That just gave you the skills that you needed to build your business, which is very, very valuable, because there's a lot of people out there that are in the 9-to-5 or the workpreneur situation. As April likes to say, that, you know, we're workpreneurs too, but that you know, are maybe learning their skills right where they are in their job, which I've also heard it, that's your first business partner. So, you know, so that's very valuable that you're able to learn all those skills like that.
Yeah. Yes. And I think everyone has these skills that they learn at work that they can easily turn into a business. Like, I had a conversation with my friends, and she was talking about her friend that all she does is she has this low ticket course where she teaches people how to set up their online calendar. I think she sells it for like $7. Did $1 million last year selling that course.
Wow.
Like, so just setting up their calendar?
Yeah, that's it. You go online, you click this button. Doo, 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 doo.
The little thing.
Yeah.
The little things. And that's crazy. She scaled like crazy. Congrats to her.
Yeah, it just goes to
Because
show you that not to take your skills for granted, because there are people out there that don't know everything. And so you can bring a lot of
exactly.
value to the table. That's awesome.
Exactly. What comes easy to you comes harder for other people. Like I tell people, y'all see me do this business stuff. I'm like, yo, you crush it. I say, y'all ain't see me try to put the toothpaste on the toothbrush when the tube get too low. Like, I gotta call my wife for help. Babes, babes, I can't get the
Hey, we all have our different strengths and weaknesses,
Exactly. So
so what
just
did you
because
end
you
up
can do something
doing?
easy doesn't mean what you do isn't valuable.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yeah, but we f suffer from it's just me itis. Oh, it's just me. Oh, yeah, I've always done this. This is nothing. Meanwhile, the world looks at your gift and they're amazed by it. But because it's our gift, we don't value it.
So
Right.
true.
And sometimes, I guess if you don't know, like sometimes if you're examining yourself and your gifts, you don't really like it's, you think it's something minute or anything like that, but you don't see it as a gift, and you wouldn't think, oh, that thing, that's not really valuable. What would people do with that? But you'd be surprised, I guess, because with the example with the calendar, where she's, wow, she's killing it. With a small course like that, so that's great.
Exactly. Small things that we perceive as small. But people becoming millionaires from cleaning, from cooking, teaching people how to cook, from doing interviews, doing podcasts. I'm just a curious person. I like to meet people and have conversations. So let me start a podcast and make $1 million talking to people.
Right, that's
Talking to
cool.
people.
Absolutely. We're on our journey right now, and we've seen organic growth in our podcast, but we're on our journey in real time, so it's exciting. Yeah, so
Yeah, absolutely. And it's crazy because when the time comes, the click and the shift is just so, it's like you don't even realize it. Like, I didn't realize I had anything significant until people started to point it out to me because you get so caught up into it, right? Like, you can't see the big picture when you're in the picture.
right.
Like, even when it came to me starting my coaching business, it was ridiculous because I'm thinking, like, I never worked the 40 happened when we had 1 month. It was typically like 4 weeks in a month. And people hit me up like, yo, like, do you even work anymore? I'm yeah, bro, I work. Like, we all work. Like, what you mean? Yeah, I've been watching you on social media. And they saw me the first week. I'm in Houston, Texas, hanging out with friends. I live in Charlotte, North Carolina. So I'm in Houston, Texas. The next week, I'm in St. Louis, Missouri. The third week, I'm back in town. And then the fourth week, we at Disney. Like, bro, you don't even work. You've been traveling all month. But I still made $20,000 that month, but I only worked 10 hours.
Wow.
And I was so just into it. Like, yeah, this is just how I built my business, how I built my life. And then other people are amazed. I'm like, no, this is just what it is. It's nothing special. And then I went to start a coaching program. But in my mind, I was like, well, I'm not doing $1 million a month. So nobody wants to learn from me. Because this is just what I do. This is simple. And then my coach is like, how many people do you know that would love to work 10 hours and make $20,000?
Yes.
Right.
Yeah, you got a point.
Big point. So after the layoff, did you jump right into doing your own thing, or you got coaching and you kind of like gradually kind of leaned in, so I'm just gonna do my own thing or what?
Yeah, I wanted to, but I was listening to everybody's advice and it's like, no, you got to have something stable. You got a wife to take care of. So I end up getting a job as a general sales manager for a gym.
Okay.
And they were like, the VP was happy to hire me. Like, on the interview, my wife was like in the car. So he's like, yeah, I want to meet your wife or whatever. He knows, like, I'm never going to go without my wife. So he's like, she with you? Of course she's with me. She's always with me. So I go to the bathroom. He goes up to talk to my wife, and he goes, she's like, yeah, he's special. I ain't nothing special. But he was so excited to hire me. And this is because, like, one, he had followed me online. But two, they had this thing at the gym, which was amazing. They called it Cardio Cinema. It was a beautiful gym. It's 3 floors. There's an elevator. And on the third floor, there's a movie theater room where they're playing movies all day long. But instead of theater seats, there's treadmills and exercise bikes.
I love it.
I'm like, this is amazing. So on the job interview, I'll pull out my phone, get on Instagram, and I just start promoting. And he's like, oh, you're good with social media marketing? Oh, yeah, we need that. I know nothing about social media marketing. So he hires me. I end up buying a course I didn't have money for to learn social media marketing. And my VP, amazing guy. His boss was a racist. And it was a gym in a high-end white area of town. And he didn't want a black guy being the VP there, or being the general sales manager there. Okay. So I was the GM, but they paid me less than minimum wage. But they gave me bonuses so they could get away with it. So I'm making $6 an hour as a general manager. Everybody that works for me has a higher base salary than me. And I'm just busting my butt. And I'm learning the social media marketing. And I'm like, I could make way more money doing this for myself as a business than working here. So I talked to the operations manager. I'm like, yo, dude, I'm thinking about starting a social media marketing agency. And he's like, oh, yeah, I used to run one. And he's like, I was like, why'd you stop? He's like, bro, because I suck at sales. I couldn't sell the service. I was like, bro, I'm a master at sales. We should partner up. No. Come on, bro. We should do it. No, 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 no. He told me no for weeks. And I eventually broke him down. He's like, all right, I'll go into business with you. So we start the agency together. I leave that job, start working for a different company that end up having layoffs as well. And I was like, that's two layoffs and 6 months of getting married. I'm going all in with this agency. Because now I know how to do marketing. I can generate the leads. I can close the leads. And it seemed like it was going to be good. But I still didn't know business like that, right? So I had to hire a coach. I had to invest money I didn't have into a coach. Leverage credit. He got me into the program and everything changed. I went from my first 6 months of having the agency. We made $500 total our first 6 months. Then he's like, you need to increase your prices to $1,000. Hopped on the sales call. That person bought that day for $1,000. I was like, I was working all month long to make tiny bits of money. And now I got $1,000 for one client, doing less work than I was doing for the other clients. So then we started doing that. I was like, oh, I'm going to try to charge this next person $1,250. And then they paid. I'm going to charge the next person $1,750. And then they paid. And then I lost my mind. I got on the next call. I was like, it's going to be $6,000. And that day, that lady paid. And I was like, I have been underpricing myself for far too long. Because I had testimonials where people were making $18,000 within their first 2 weeks of working with us. And I was charging $1,000 to help you make $18,000 in 2 weeks. What?
Wow. But you had to go through those struggles to kind of see your own value. You know, you bring value everywhere you go. And it just really sucks that, you know, the places you were at did not treat you with the respect and the, you know, the hierarchy that you deserve. So I, you know, shout out to you for going to get it yourself. And I really admire the process that you had to go through to start recognizing your own value. And, you know, it's okay. Like, I think entrepreneurs, we're faced with a almost like a guilt of charging people for our services. And we try to, you know, get stuff free and cut deals and stuff. But in reality, you know, if your service is valuable, then you should charge your what it's worth. Definitely.
Exactly. I agree with you're not going to go into the Lamborghini dealership and be like, oh, I don't have the money. Can you come off this price?
Right.
You can come off our lot.
Exactly. Yeah, Pretty much.
And I like how you put it too, because so many people have that limiting belief, I think. And I struggle with it too, honestly, because, you know, I feel like, you know, me, you know, what would they want with me? Like, as a, you know, a consultant, or, you know, what value do I bring? But that's a limiting belief that I struggled with so long. But the way you put it earlier was how, since you're in the puzzle, you said you don't really see the big picture or the big puzzle, which is very, I mean, that's most people, I think. And but you were able to hire a coach to help you see the bigger picture and to help you get the confidence that you needed to know your worth and to know, hey, I am valuable. And April was saying, I hate that you had to go through that. You know, as far as, you know, I guess the learning, I guess that was learning curves for you, and and all that. So, but look where you are now, and you can see the bigger picture, and now you're coaching others. It's great. So,
it made you a warrior.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it did.
They say it make you stronger.
How did you come up with the name? Was it
Never Work the 40?
I would too.
I could see why now.
Never Work the 40.
Yeah, it all came from that 1 month where I realized I worked 10 hours. And when I like worked corporate, the original one that laid me off, my salary was $35,000 a year. Mm. And then I was like, yo, I make $6,000 service. I get four clients. That's $24,000. And then I got a team of virtual assistants handling the workload for me. So it's like, it costs me, I make $24,000. My business runs for $5,000-ish a month, give or take, ad costs. But for most months, like, I'm profiting $20,000 and I'm not working.
I love it.
So I was working like, I'm not smart, working 40 not hours hard. A week. Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
You're leveraging strategic partnerships, you know, with your team and your partners and everything like that. So that's very valuable. You know, that's a gem right there, you know.
It is. What do you coach people on?
So I help people take their knowledge, their expertise, like we were talking about earlier, those little gifts that we undervalue, packaging it up into a program and launching it so that they can finally teach other people who want to know what they already know and helping them make $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 in a single day.
Love it. In a day.
In a day.
I thought that was a month. In a day. Oh, wow. In a day.
Yeah, because I just realized it's easier to make a lot of money in a short period of time then to make a little bit of money over a long period of time. Mm. Like one of the biggest shifts that came from me was I actually learned it from Bob Proctor years ago. He said, there's one reason and one reason only that someone makes $100,000 a year. And when he said that, I'm like, well, I'm not making $100,000 a year at this point. So I was like, Uncle Bob, I'm listening. What's the one reason? And the answer isn't what I thought it would be. He said, there's one reason and one reason only someone makes $100,000 a year. And it's simply because they're unaware of the fact that they could be making $100,000 a month.
Oh.
And I was like,
that's a mic drop.
Yeah. So that's Jeremy, the only reason you make $35,000 a year is because you don't realize you can make $35,000 a month. And then I took a step forward as I got to that point. It's like the only reason you're gonna make $35,000 a month is because you don't realize you could have did that in a single day.
That's a perspective change right there. You know, it'll definitely change your perspective.
Yeah. And it's really easy. It's really easy.
How do you help people come with it? They have limiting beliefs. And I struggle with it too. I struggle with limiting beliefs. You know, I'm better as I'm seasoned in my life. You know, I've went through some life challenges and things like that. And I think I'm doing a lot better. But I mean, they still creep up. You know, they still creep up. But how do you coach people through that to realize, hey, I could make these, you know, $30,000 a day, or you know, how do you get them to change that mindset or to make the perspective change? How do you coach them through that?
I have to help them transform their identity. Because until I do that, nothing else happens.
Okay.
So I typically tell people when it comes to mentorship, transactions become time machines for your transformation.
Mm.
So the only reason I couldn't charge somebody $1,000 for my service previously is because I never paid anyone $1,000. So my mindset is nobody will pay that much money. But when I start paying $5,000 for a coach, $10,000 for a coach, $25,000, $30,000, now, all of a sudden, it's like, once I've paid it, I am proof positive that someone will pay that. Even I join the programs, I see other people that paid it. Mm-hmm. So now it's like, okay, well, the same guy that made me made them. And I understand how capitalism works. I have something of value, and I exchange something of value for someone else's value, i.e. I have a result that someone wants value. They have money that they'll rather trade to get the result. And we have an exchange of value. So if I know someone will pay someone else $30,000, why wouldn't they pay me $30,000, right, if I can provide value worth $300,000?
Right.
So, but until you break that barrier of pain of payment, most people never can make the mindset shift. And honestly, most people shouldn't, because you should never ask somebody to do something that you're not willing to do.
Very true.
That's true.
It's definitely heavy on the mindset. What would you say to someone who lacks an execution? Because after the mindset, you got to execute.
I become the person. It's all identity. Because if you become the person, so if you want to, let's call it the result, the outcome is having a $20,000 day. All I have to do is help you become the person that can have a $20,000 day, and you will automatically do everything that that person would do. And if you do what that person would do, you will have the result that that person wants to have.
I love it.
So it all comes from being your identity.
I love it. Because I think everybody has their own superpower, strength, just something that is unique to them that they offer to other people. And like you said, it's just a matter of packaging it and letting people know, because if nobody knows you have it, it's you can't do anything with it.
That's true.
Exactly.
Yeah, and there's certainly folks out there that are on different levels of their, I call mine my transformation journey. So I'm on mine right now, and so people are on different areas or different, I guess, points in their progress on their transformation journeys, and so they just have to realize the value that they have, and then be willing to either find it for themselves, which will be the slow route, right? Or to get a coach and a team and strategic partnerships, so that will be to make it faster, to kind of expedite things, I think. So it's all a change of perspective, a change of mindset. And it's good that you are able to help people with that. So,
Totally, yes.
yeah.
That's what it comes down to. It's really three parts I teach people if they want to guarantee their success. And we call it the progress triangle. The top of the triangle is pain of payment. It's paying so much money where basically, like, the reason we buy books and don't read the book is because we buy the book thinking grow rich. Oh, I'm going to grow rich. And then you got that dopamine hit. And then you're like, yeah, I'm going to do it. But you only paid $20 for the book. So it sits on your shelf because it didn't hurt you. But if you pay $20,000 for it, you get that excitement, but then the fear chemicals kick in as well. You're like, I have to get a return on this investment, or I just wasted $20,000. Harvard actually did a study and showed that when you embrace pain and payment, the chances of you hitting your goal goes up by over 800%. There's an 8x increase in the chances of you actually getting the results that you want to hit. So that's the top of the pyramid. The next part is the group accountability effect. Once you get into a community that can hold you accountable, now your chances of success go up another 500%. So you got another 5x increase just by having somebody. That's why if you're going to the gym, if you're going by yourself, you might go, you might not. But you got your girlfriend going to the gym with you. She don't want to tell you, oh, I'm not showing up. You don't want to tell her, oh, I'm not showing up.
Right.
So now you both show up. You just got a 500% increase in the chances of success. Then
Wow.
the other thing is the calendar effect. That one also increases another 500% because commitments only show up in two places, in your bank accounts and on your calendar. You show me your bank account, you show me your bank statement, you show me your calendar, I'll show you exactly where your commitments are. You're
Oh.
not committed to your dream, you're committed to Chipotle.
Oh.
Yeah.
That cuts some folks.
That it did, but you know what? It's true.
Yeah, man. It's the
Yeah.
harsh truth that people need to hear, like what do you consider a priority? You can't cry about not having this, not having that, but spend your time in things that don't produce those things,
Yeah, and it
Yep.
makes sense where you said pain of payment, because it's true. Like if you drop that amount of money, you're going to be very motivated to get a return on that, so.
Exactly. It's like, why would people pay me $15,000 for 6 hours of coaching? It's
Right.
because right after that, they typically make $20,000 in a single day within the next 2 weeks.
So yeah, it's about bringing value and getting a return on your investment for sure.
Exactly. And now I open up that whole program where people don't have to pay me $15,000 anymore.
So tell us about your program. What's this program? Let's be nosy.
Yes, the same program. We call it Phantom Launch Secrets or the Phantom Launch Secrets of a $20,000 day. I teach people the same process. It's a 6-week process we take people through from if you don't have a program You go from absolute nowhere to a $20,000 day within 6 weeks. Very simple program. We help you solidify your message, share that message, scale that message. So, in other words, we're going to help you with the mindset. We're going to help you with the market research, creating an offer that people will be willing to pay $10,000 for. And that's the secret. You only have to make two sales of $10,000 to have a $20,000 day. So, I'm going to teach you how to have a virtual event like a webinar, a masterclass, a challenge where you can get 40, 50 people on, and all you need is two of them to buy. And you're going to have a $20,000 day. So I create a program where we teach the whole thing, get you into a community of other people that's on that same path. You can be around other people that say, yeah, I had a $20,000 day in 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 8 weeks. And you get around this community, the people that's doing it. So now it's real to you.
I want to talk about the strength of a community and being around like-minded people. How did that help you shift?
Yeah, it's that group accountability effect, right? So it's just like in the Navy SEALs, they did this research and it was like, how come some people quit during Hell Week and others don't? If you guys don't understand Hell Week, it's like they throw you into the water, Coronado, like in this crazy, like it's designed to break you. And there's a bell, you can go ring the bell and quit at any point. They did this research and they found out this person quit, but not only did they quit, everybody they trained with quit. This person succeeded, but not only did they succeed, everybody they trained with succeeded. Why? What's the ones that succeeded? They said, hey, they're going to try to break us. Things are going to get tough. When I give you the look, that means I'm in here with you. I got your back. We're in this together. We're not going to give up. So everybody that was in that group, they succeeded. The people that failed, they didn't have that. They were individuals in that water. Just suffering. Family, I'm here to tell everybody watching, life is going to hit you. Life is going to get tough. If you don't have people in your circle that you can look at and say, hey, I got your back, you got my back, it's going to work out. Environment's everything because the environment will shift the individual before the individual shifts the environment. There's so much power and proximity, you can't even express it to the closeness to the value it actually brings.
Oh,
So it
that's so
shifted
true.
as soon as I got around other people, right? One of my friends found out I was only making $20,000 a month. And he paused and said, oh, really? I don't know how to say this, but you're the only person I talk to like this that doesn't make at least $100,000 a month.
Wow.
It felt the pain in my heart. I was like, golly. But I needed him to say that.
It made you want to step it up a notch or two.
Exactly. I always say a real friend doesn't stab you in the back. They stab you right straight square in the front.
Wow.
It's true. The Bible says, faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of the enemy are deceitful.
No, that's true.
Yeah.
Me and my friend joke around and about talking about each other behind each other's back and stuff, and we always say, "No, nah, I say it in your face."
Exactly. And we
Right.
need the
And
truth because the truth might
yeah.
hurt. The truth will never harm you.
Exactly. And then and the people that you surround yourself with, you got to know that they're there in all areas at times. When it gets rough and hard and you're in the trenches of everything and it's so like you feel like everything's buried, burying you in and stuff, the people that are there with you in those toughest times are the ones you want to stay with or stay around you. They're going to lift you up instead of run away when you're having struggles, So you got to be around the
Exactly.
right people, the right groups, the right
Right.
mentorships, so.
Yep, that's everything. I won't let anybody into my circle that's not in total alignment.
Oh, that's
So
right.
valuable.
Where can people find you, Jeremy? How can we find out about your if people wanted to connect with you or kind of see some of your stuff, join your mentorship or join your co coaching program, I'm sorry.
Yeah, same thing, mentorship, coaching program. I get so much access to me, it's ridiculous. But yeah, follow me socials at The Real Jeremy F. There are some fake accounts out there. So
Oh.
at The Real Jeremy F. And you guys can go to neverworkthe40.com, neverworkthe40, like the actual number 40, neverworkthe40.com. And you can go in there. It's actually, you can opt in and see a case study of one of my clients, Elizabeth. And she's just talking about her journey of her $20,000 a day. It only took her 8 weeks to do it, of being in the program. She paid the high ticket price to work with me for 6 weeks. But she literally had a program that she was working 12-week program, charging $1,200 for it. We helped her increase the value of the program, condense it to a 6-week program, charge $10,000 for it, and had two people buy 2 weeks after she got done coaching with us.
Wow. So awesome.
So there's about a little over 3 minutes left. Yeah. So like, if you had some final words of wisdom or words of advice for people out there, or, you know, give us more encouragement, like, what would you say?
Yeah, I would say everybody should create some type of info product, whether it's a course, a curriculum, a coaching program. Everybody should do that, because if we just look back in time, like, I'm a guy that likes to identify trends. And like Wayne Gretzky, they said, how were you so good? He said, because I didn't skate to where the puck was. I skated to where the puck was going. Mm-hmm. In other words, I can look at trends of the past and then look at where things are going in the future and position myself to capitalize. So when I look back in time and see, we have the agricultural age where people were farmers, whoever had the land had the wealth, until we moved to the industrial age, where now where whoever had the machines had the wealth. Well, now we're in the information age. So guess what? Whoever has the information has the wealth. Everyone should take the information they have in their mind and package it and use it to bless other people. Because it's just my belief, God watches how we steward things. And I believe that Jesus said, my sheep know my voice. I think we all have sheep out there that are just waiting for our voice that we're not using. In other words, we're not stewarding our voices, and we're not stewarding the expertise that God gave us. So now we can't bless his people. And most of us are blocking our blessings because we're just caught up in it's just me-itis. And we don't see our greatness.
Ooh, that's some hot fire right there. Fire in the chat. I've never heard it put that way. So I love your analysis about the information era. We are definitely in the information era.
Yes, and I love the bringing in the analogy with the stewardship with God, because it's so true. Like, you know, you gotta use the blessings that God's given you, so that he can, you know, you can live in more abundance. He can trust you with more, you know, if you use what he's given you and steward it in the way he wants you to. So valuable. Yes,
you are definitely a vessel. I feel like he is using you, and definitely happy for you and thankful for you. Congratulations. I don't know how long y'all been married, but congratulations on that.
I celebrated 5 years last month.
5 years. Right.
Congratulations.
Happy anniversary.
Yeah.
I know you guys got so much more greatness to achieve together. So congratulations, and thank you so much for coming on.
Yeah. And I will say, if you guys want advantage of the community, guys, just $1, you get a trial access, and just $97 after that. So
thank you. Thank
Links
you
will
that.
Be in the description, guys.
Yeah. Thank you so much. We hope to have you on again in the future for updates. Awesome. Y'all have a great night. Bye, y'all.
Bye.